Absolute wonderful day. We had two powerful services this morning. Pastor Ray shared a message about experiencing God, not just knowing Him, but experiencing Him. And I'm so thankful that this morning we had the opportunity to do just that with His presence that was here this morning. They shared a video this morning as well where Pastor Watkins had shared about how we really didn't know what we had here. He said that we have something very special. Something he wasn't able to find in a lot of places. I think what he was talking about was the Spirit of the Lord, the presence that we feel in this house. And it's not something to be arrogant about, to be proud about, something to be humbled by, because a lot of people don't get that. And I'm so thankful that God honors us and comes here and visits us like he did this morning. And I don't know about you, but I'm looking forward to getting back into his presence tonight. His word says that he inhabits the praise of his people. And if we've come hungry tonight, if we've come on fire, if we've come with a passion to worship him, he'll be here. And there's no better place to be than to be in his presence. Can I get an amen? Amen. Well, let's get out in the aisles this evening. Get things started. And let's get in his presence.
Jesus is lifted. anybody desire that with all of your heart, not just a little bit of your heart, but with everything you have, for revival fire to burn in our church, to burn in our hearts, to burn in our homes. I don't know about you, but if we've ever needed God to just break out and be God, we need it now. Amen. We need His fire. Would you do something for me? Would you, right where you are, however you want to express it, would we just seek the Lord right now, put our hand on our heart, hands to the sky, however we do that fire. God, we love You tonight, God, and we praise You. Nothing more, God, do we need than Your precious presence, God. I don't want to come into this place and forsake it. I don't want to come in and reach towards something that's uncommon in a common way, God. I don't want to approach Your holy presence, God, in such a way that, God, it's not inviting to You. God, it's not honoring to You. God, we love You. We praise You. We need You. We cry out to You even tonight. God, on this cold night, God, we ask for Your fire to burn in us, God, and through us, God, and to us tonight in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we pray. We pray tonight in Jesus' name. Would you clap your hands and rejoice? Thank the Lord tonight. Very quickly, if you want to be seated tonight, we're going to go into, I'm just going to tell you, it makes me proud. It makes me proud to see young people that want to lead people into the presence of the Lord. I know that my girls, we go to plays and we go to different things that they're singing and they're performing. But we teach our kids and raise our kids up that when we sing, we're not performing, we're ministering. And I know they've been readying themselves for weeks, and today especially, wanting God and the power of God to move upon us tonight in a powerful way. As we go into the next part of the service and prayer, over prayer requests and offering, Psalms chapter 4 says, "Answer me when I call to You, O my righteous God. Give me relief from my distress. Be merciful to me and hear my prayer. How long, O men, will you turn my glory into shame? How long will you love delusions and seek false gods? Know that the Lord has set apart the godly. Know that the Lord has set apart the godly for Himself. And the Lord will hear when I call to Him." And I want you to hear this. It says, "In your anger, do not sin. And when you're on your beds, search your hearts and be silent." And it says this. It says, "Offer right sacrifices and trust in the Lord." I'm thankful for the grace of Jesus Christ. I'm thankful for God's grace in my life. I would be nothing and nowhere without God's grace. But God is teaching me that I don't need to approach God's grace in a common way. I don't need to approach God's grace in even a cheap way. I need to approach God's grace in a way that I'm grateful, in a way that I'm thankful, in a way that my heart is totally indebted to Him and my life is totally indebted to Him. What this scripture, I've read this every day. I feel like the Holy Spirit has taken me back to it. It says, "Offer right sacrifices and trust in the Lord." It says to me, and I want to say it tonight, that just offering a sacrifice, just offering a sacrifice doesn't necessarily honor the Lord, but a right sacrifice. And I know our hearts tonight are to offer a right sacrifice to the Lord and to trust in Him and to do it in a way that honors Him tonight. And I don't just mean about our offering. I mean our lives. I mean everything that we have, desire to be, hope to be tonight. As we give tonight, we want you to give as God leads you, as you're able. But I want to tell you tonight and challenge you tonight as God moves us as people and His people into new places with Him, and to a new year with Him, and our relationship grows deeper and things change and shift in our lives. I want to be this. I want to offer a right sacrifice. I want my life to honor Him. I want it to honor Him. I want to give something that He's worthy of. I want to give something that honors Him with everything that I have tonight. God, we praise You and we worship You. And God, I just pray tonight. God, I pray that we wouldn't come and give an offering that's callous, God. And we're not talking, God, of even our finances. We're talking about us tonight. God, we desire to be pleasing in Your sight, God, through Your blood. And God, as we worship tonight, I pray You'd be honored. I pray You'd be glorified. I pray as we came in today that it wouldn't be our worship, it'd be Yours. God, it'd be our heart. We'd be broken to please you. We'd be broken to be in your presence. We'd be broken tonight to be more like you in all that we do and say. And God, we are honored tonight for that opportunity. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Telling you tonight, he cannot fail. His words do not fail you tonight. They do not fail. I'm so thankful for that. I'm holding on to a lot of things, and I know that he's faithful. I know that he is. In Jesus' name, has he ever came through for you? Has he ever came through for you? He will again and again and again. Amen. Love the Lord with us tonight. You can't go wrong with a song, and I've said this before, any song that lifts him up and says, I love you.
I love you, Lord.
Praise, and stand up tonight.
Lord, I glorify your name.
Oh, my Lord.
Lord,
we give you praise tonight, Lord.
Lord, I glorify your name.
How many of you know tonight the power of the Lord is here? I said, how many of you know the power of the Lord is here tonight? We have come together in God's house, in His presence, and I am just believing that we haven't come by here to just go through the motions of another Sunday night. I want you to lift your hands. I want you to give God praise. I want you to search down inside you where your spirit is just full of fire of God. I want you to give Him the praise He's worthy of. It may be cold outside, but it ought to be red hot in here, because we have a God who is the author and the finisher of our faith. He is a mighty God, and He deserves our worship. Would you do that? Would you just begin to praise Him? Honor Him tonight in the name of the Lord. Father, we lift you up. We give you praise. We praise and honor your name tonight, God. We give you the glory and we give you the honor. We give you praise. Lord, the rocks won't cry out for us tonight. We're giving you the glory and the honor. We thank you for it, Jesus. We give you praise, Jesus. We give you glory, Lord. Give the young people a great hand tonight. The power of the Lord working through them. Aren't you proud of our young people? I'm so proud. They got great voices. They got great anointing. I thank you guys for the sacrifice. I thank you that you're committed. You're dedicated. You're able to come out here on a Sunday in the main services of the church, and you are able to take us right into the presence of God. How many of you know that is not something you can just do? That's something that comes with an anointing of the Holy Spirit. And I'm thankful for these young people. One more time, give it up and give them praise. Give praise to God and give them a hand clap of whatever. Amen. I get excited. I get excited. I love seeing young people on fire for the Lord. I love them. I love seeing them involved in committed and dedicated ministry. I love watching you as you worship, as you sing. You sing awesome. They don't just sing okay. They don't just sing all right. They sing great. They got an anointing on them. They got powerful voices in that choir. I could listen to them all night long. Thankful, guys. I love you. And get ready for church. While you're standing, I want you to turn to the Word. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 13. Guess we should thank Angie, too. Angie's their director, and she does a great job working with our young people. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 13. Nothing in all creation is hidden from God's sight. Everything is uncovered and laid bare to Him to whom we must give account. How many of you know we all got to give account to the Lord? We all got to give account to the Lord. The Bible says and we talked about it this morning, we can know God. And boy, that what a desire that is in my own heart and in so many of you. We can know God. He's not just some mythical figure. He's not some invisible force. Has to be awakened like Star Wars. He's not just some statue in some Buddhist temple somewhere or some temple around the world. He's God. And he can be known. How many of you know him tonight? You testify, I know him. I know him for myself. I don't have someone else's encounter. I don't have secondhand information or knowledge. I know the Lord for myself. I found him to be there in my life. I found him there in the good times. I found him in the bad times. I found that the Lord has been faithful to me. Sometimes I will ask the questions. I'll say, God, where are you? What's going on? And God, he doesn't go, hey, I'm right here. Don't worry, I'm right here. No, he just reminds me who he is. That he never leaves. That he's faithful to 1,000 generations. That he's always on time. He's always awake. He's always in control. How many of you know it's a big word, but how many of you understand and know what it means when I say he is sovereign? God is sovereign. He's in control. And when I know that, and when I experience that in my life, I don't worry about a thing. Take it all. Take everything I got. Take everything this world has. I don't need it as long as I know that God is in control and I have him in my life. We can know God. You can't really trust God until you first know God. I'll say that again. You can't really trust God if you don't know God. It should be your grandest desire, your deepest hunger and thirst in your life to know God for yourself. I don't understand people that have nothing but a secondhand knowledge, as we talked about this morning. Secondhand knowledge. Why do you believe what you believe? Well, it's what I've been taught. Well, that's the worst answer you could ever give. Well, it's what my mama raised us, all of us kids, to believe. Well, what my daddy raised us all to believe. That's the worst answer you could give. I love Sister Landreth when she got up at Old Harlem Park Church. I'll never forget it. It was about 30 years ago, but I have never forgotten it. She was sitting on the front row down at Harlem Park Church of God. She stood up and she said, I know that I know that I know that I know. And man, she didn't say, that wasn't a whole lot of words. That wasn't a big old theological dissertation on anything. But I tell you what, it tore that house up. Because everybody knew what she was talking about. She said, I know that I know that I know that I know that he's my Lord. That he has saved me. She said, he woke me up this morning. She said, he has kept me all day long. When I lay my head on my pillow tonight, he is going to be right there. I know. My Lord is my Savior. I know he's my Redeemer. Amen. Do you know that tonight? We know it. I read the scripture for you this morning from Job, and I'm going to sit you down in just a moment. We're going to pray. Job 42 and verses 5 through 6. I'm considering this just kind of like a continuation of where we were this morning. The Lord is not done with this message. Job said this after he had gone through the worst trials, the worst storms, call it what you want, fire, wind, rain, water, flood, whatever you want to call it. I'm amazed sometimes at what people go through. They'll say, well, I'm just going through the flood. Okay. Well, Pastor, pray for me. I'm going through the fire. All right. Well, which is it, fire or the flood? The water, the storm, the trial? What is it? I guess if you want to know how it all works, the devil comes in any old way he can. Sometimes he comes in through the waters. It'll feel like you're drowning. feel like you can't find no way out, feels like you're being suffocated by your circumstances, and you don't know what your next step's going to be. You can't swim out. You can't do nothing. Other times, you'll feel the heat of it, and you'll feel like, man, I'm in the fire. I'm going through the fire. It don't matter what it is. What's awesome, Beetle, what's awesome is that in all of it, whether it be the fire or it be the wind or it be the rain or it be the flood, if it's cold or if it's the hot, no matter what it is, what's awesome for us to know is that God is in control and God is still on the throne and He is God over all of the elements, every trial, every circumstance that'll ever come against you. And how many of you know nothing is too hard for God? I said, how many of you know nothing is too hard for God? God can heal anything. God can heal cancer. God can heal you where you sit. God can heal your back, your neck, your arm, your leg. God can heal it all. God can heal your kneecap. I've been having a little knee problem. I'm believing God. Sister Boyer, I'm believing God. I prayed with you on the phone one night. Boy, the Lord fell right there on the telephone line. How does He do that? God heals. I'm believing God to heal my kneecap. I've got a little problem. I did some grout on some tile floor, and I'm just not accepting this. I know He's my healer. I know it's not His will that I limp around looking like I'm 98. It's not His will. So I'm believing that God's going to deliver me, and I already feel better while I'm even saying that. I feel that it can happen just like that. Listen to me, young people. That's the kind of God we're looking to serve and to live with for all of eternity. I'm not talking about no God of religion. I'm not talking about no God that's all in the do's and the don'ts and it's all in all this denominational doctrines and everybody debating and fighting over who's right and who's wrong. I'm talking about the God who set the sun out this morning and the God who set the moon out tonight. I'm talking about the God who puts the air in your lungs that you're breathing right now, that lets you have the heartbeat in your body. That God is who we're serving. That's the God that we love tonight and we honor. That's the God that's in control. I said, that's the God that's in control. Somebody says, you get way too excited. You get way too emotional. Okay. Get over yourself. I watch people go crazy over a lottery ticket. I watch people screaming, hooting, and hollering over everything from a leather football to a basketball. I watch them go nuts over a rock star and a celebrity. I'll tell you, the greatest celebrity known to mankind is in this house tonight. And I'm going to get excited about him being... Oh! I'm going to get excited about the fact that he's my healer. He delivers me. If you see me doing this every now and again, I'm just checking it out. I feel good. It feels good. Marty, you know, you've been watching me. I couldn't do nothing. My guests, they've been watching me limp around. Poor little Kayla, she got down next to me the other night in the beautiful, cutest little Australian accent. She was praying a little prayer for me. It was probably the most awesome prayer I've ever heard in my life. It's that little sweetheart was praying over me. Her mommy and daddy praying over me, laying hands on my kneecap. I feel the healer is in the house tonight. I feel the healer is in the house. I believe He'll heal your lungs. I believe He'll heal your heart. I believe right now, let's just stop right now. If you need a healing tonight, I want you to lift your hands because the healer is in the house tonight. I believe He's here right now. Oh, Rabbi Yandarabekohosi. In the name of Jesus, Father, we believe in the power of Pentecost. We believe in the power of the Holy Spirit that it's work. We believe, Lord, we look at world events. We understand Israel is God's chosen people, surrounded by their enemies on every side, in the news still every day, even though they were written about thousands and thousands of years ago in your word. But here they are tonight, God, no bigger than the state of New Jersey, but protected on every side because you are God and you're in control. I pray right now that the God who helps Israel, the God who provides for Israel, the God who keeps the sun and the moon and the stars and the planets all in line, that same God heal bodies this night. I pray for heart disease. I pray for asthmatic disease. I pray, Lord, for Alzheimer's. If anyone's got any recessive genes or if the enemy's trying to attack their body physically like that, I come against it tonight. I come against the flu. I come against, Lord, livers got problems. I come against kidneys that have problems. And I pray it in the mighty, mighty name of Jesus Christ. not because of who I am, not because of the words I speak, but because I have called on the name that is above every name, the name of Jesus Christ. I thank you, Father. Would you put your hands together? Let's give the Lord great praise. You see, I believe in this thing. Does that mean I'm perfect? No. Do you believe I walk around with a big old halo on my head and wings coming out my back? No. I'm human, just like you are. Well, I get up every morning. Sometimes I feel good. Sometimes I don't feel good. Sometimes I feel saved. Sometimes I don't feel saved. There are times I'm going through a hard time or a bad day. That don't make God any less real or any less powerful or any less God. It's time for us to get a fresh vision of who He is and understand that we can know Him. If you stand back here tonight and you're like, well, I don't know what I believe. I don't know if these people are a bunch of kooks or not. Understand something. You can know for yourself. I'm not trying to push nothing. I'm not trying to sell something. I'm not trying to get you to sign on any dotted line and put your life on the line. I'm not trying to get you to sell flowers in the airport. I'm not trying to drain your bank account. What I'm trying to tell you tonight is that God is real. His power is real. And you can know it for yourself. And I'm praying right now in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, you convict hearts. You knock on hearts' doors. Lord, people need to know you're real. They need to know your power is real. They need to know, God, that we're approaching the very last minutes of time. And they'll wake up one morning and all of us kooks and all of us crazy folks, we'll all be out of their hair because we'll be gone. We'll be celebrating around the marriage supper of the Lamb. The Bible is coming to life right in front of our eyes. And Lord, I want every man, every woman, boy and girl in this house, I want them to know and to realize I don't want them to leave this place. I don't want them walking out to their car until they have made things right with the author and the finisher of faith, Jesus Christ. I want them to know you and your power. Paul, going on his way, he thought they were a bunch of kooks too. He thought they were a bunch of idiots and a bunch of folks that didn't have a clue. But Lord, on that Damascus road, you stopped him dead in his tracks and you turned his life around. I'm praying right now you'll turn the life of people in this house around, that they'll have a Damascus road experience where they will feel and sense the truth of Almighty God in this house right now. I'm praying for it in the Holy Spirit. I pray in the name of Jesus. Are you agreeing with me right now? I believe there are people here tonight that don't know what they believe. They don't know what they think about God. And they have to know. They have to know. God's got to be real in their lives. It's our responsibility as a church to get past all that religious stuff and move past all that stuff that blinds people and stumbles, causes people to stumble and hurts them. And we got to get past our own hypocrisies. And we got to get authentic and real and know that God is trying to save people. God is trying to rescue people. They're seeking all in the wrong areas. They're seeking all the wrong answers in their lives. Oh, I feel a heaviness tonight. Who in the world are you? Who in the world is here tonight that is so heavy? I'm telling you, it's time to stop playing a game. If that's what's happening, it's time to stop running around in circles. It's time to stop leaning on mommy and daddy's religion. It's time to start knowing God for yourself. Hear me, young people. It's time to stop living on somebody else's prayers, somebody else's religion. It's time for you and I to get together tonight. It's time for you to start seeking the face of God for yourself. God's going to call some of you to ministry. He's going to call some of you missionary work. Some of you are going to be called to preach. Some of you are going to be called to do mighty and wonderful things for God. Every youth leader in the house ought to be praying right now, telling you, young people, God called out Daniel and his three friends because they had an excellent spirit. Where are the excellent spirits? Where are the hearts for God? I'm telling you, I'm talking about something that's real. It's more real than the Obama and the White House and the Biden White House. It's more real than the Democrats and the Republicans. It's more real than the election going on, than the debates on TV. I'm telling you, what's more real is what you're sensing and what you're hearing right now. God is real. God is real. People turn to alcohol, they turn to drugs, they turn to pills, they turn to all these things to try to help them cope with life. They can't handle life. They're full of stress and anxiety. They have no answers to anything going on in their life, so they got to cover it all up with all these substances. And then they're running all over the place a little bit later trying to get free from all that. They live their life broke trying to get free from all that stuff they were running to try to get free the first time around. Let me tell you, that's a bunch of circles. That ain't gonna get you anywhere. This one narrow path that'll take you straight to truth. And if you'll hear me tonight and if you'll respond, the Holy Spirit is here. Are you praying with me, Christians? God's doing something right now. I feel it in the Spirit. Oh, Rabbi Yanda Rabakohosi. Holy Spirit, touch your people and minister. Minister, God, to the hurting. Minister to the confused. Minister, Lord, to those that can't fix themselves, those that, God, they have no answers. They're seeking all the answers in all the wrong ways, in all the wrong places, and Lord, they don't know what to do. They feel like they're living two lives. They're living like a two-sided coin. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus, you touch them tonight. Minister by your Holy Spirit and touch people to truly, truly come to the fountain of living water. Living water. Jesus, you said if you'll just take a drink, if you'll just take a drink of what I offer you, you'll never thirst again. Your heart will be satisfied. Your life will be satisfied. You'll get on a path headed towards destiny and truth, and you're going to have the victory. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Glory to God. I need some intercessors. There's some that are interceding right now. If you're filled with the Holy Ghost right now, I want you to begin to intercede in this house. I'm telling you, it's a work the Spirit's going to do. It's a work the Holy Ghost is going to do, not us. Oh, Lord, we praise you. Oh, Lord, we praise you. Jesus, we love you. We honor you tonight. Lord, break the yoke that binds us, that holds us back. The yokes, God, on people there. Yokes of stress and anxiety. Yokes, Lord, of worldliness. God, people have gotten cold and indifferent. There's coldness in this house, Lord. There's a chill in here, even though the Holy Ghost is moving. God, people have gotten lax in their relationship with you. They've gotten cold and indifferent. And Lord, they're now remembering what it used to be like. They're remembering back to the night that they first got saved when they cried their way into repentance in an altar. Lord, I pray you'll bring it back to their remembrance. Take us back tonight, Lord, and let us remember what it was like when we first fell in love with you. Take us back to our first love. In the name of Jesus Christ. You think that you would hide from me. You think that I don't know and that I don't see. I see all and I know. I know the pain. I know the hurt. I know the woundedness in your spirit. I know that you have sought other means to try to satisfy and to cure what ails you. You have sought those things in vain, says the Lord. I know you. I love you. I will deliver you. Come to me. Trust in me. Cast yourself upon me and watch my power as it unfolds in your life and begins a work that you will never be able to accomplish on your own. Look to me tonight and I will set you free. You try desperately to breathe. You want desperately to be able to walk. You try so difficult and hard to conquer your own issues and concerns. You feel as if you are drowning, says the Lord. Look to me. I will rescue as I did Peter. As he came out upon the waters to me, I called him out by faith, and I call you out by faith. Step out of the boat. Trust in me. Walk towards me tonight and watch. My hand is not shortened that it cannot deliver you and save you. I'm here tonight. Trust in me, says God. Wow. Hallelujah. With every head bowed and every eye closed, Father, I pray in the name of Jesus that your Holy Spirit, Lord, would arrest and touch hearts that are in here tonight. I am believing you, Lord, to do something that we cannot do on our own. I can't convince anybody. I'm not trying to sell anything. Lord, there is a supernatural move of your Spirit here in this house tonight. You have invaded this service for someone. You have felt those things that the Holy Spirit has just, through the gift of tongues and interpretation, has brought out in this service. You have felt the struggle. You have felt like you can't walk right. You can't walk the walk, the life that you want. You feel like you're drowning. You feel as if you can't breathe. I don't know what that meant. You do. Feel like you're suffocating. You can't breathe. God is making it very clear that he knows you. He sees where you are, and he wants to deliver you and help you tonight. But you have got to step out. Just because deliverance is offered here in this house tonight doesn't mean you're going to get it. Just because the Bible says that you can be free doesn't mean it's going to happen in you. Just because Jesus died on the cross for sinners all over the whole world doesn't mean it's going to do a thing for you. Because you see, while you cannot save yourself and you cannot deliver yourself, you can step out by faith and accept his help. But you've got to do that. You have to make the first move towards God. When you just surrender, it's not about works, it's about surrender. And when you surrender to God and you say, I need you, I cannot fix me, I cannot take care of my circumstances, I can't change my life, I can't do this, it's not in my power, God, I come to you. When you surrender like that, let me tell you something. An army of angels will be dispatched right from the throne room. And they'll come down and they'll surround you. The Bible says that the angels of the Lord will encamp round about you. That they'll protect you and they'll be there for you. He's got angels that'll come to your aid. Ministering angels came to Jesus at the end of his fast and temptation in the wilderness. They sent ministering angels. Heaven sends angels to come and be right there by your side. And Jesus, that healer and that refuge, that strong tower, that deliverer, Jesus himself is the one who gives you your freedom, your deliverance, and he's here tonight. If you're here and you need that, you need him and you're willing to step out, I want you to get out from where you are and come down to the front of this altar. Our pastors are going to come. I just want you to be brave. I want you to be courageous. I want you to step out where you are and make your way as fast as you can. Don't look for other people. You be the first. Just step out where I need God. I need help. I can't do this on my own. Thank you, young people. You're on my heart tonight. I'm burdened for you tonight. I know the devil wants to kill you and destroy you. Thank you for coming. Parents, I want you to come. Would you, if your son or daughter's not here, I want you to come. Pray for some of these others that are around the altar, these adults that have come, these men and women. I want prayer warriors to come. We'll get to the rest of the service, but let's take a few moments and help these folks get to victory in their lives. Would you do that right now? Would you, if you're standing back, would you just reach over and take the hand of somebody standing right beside you or right there by you? And would you begin to intercede and pray for these? That I believe that there is some major stuff going on in this altar tonight. I know what the Holy Spirit is speaking to me. There's people in here that's on dangerous ground. There's people in this house that are on dangerous ground. Life is going to change for you whether you accept this help or not. Life is going to change for you. You have got to be ready to make the decision for Christ, and you've got to allow the Lord to help you, because I'm telling you, you're fixing to go into a storm like you have never been in before in your life, and things are going to change for you. If I were you, I would get here as quickly as I could. Sing.
Hold my every moment.
If you're stepping back, I want you to just keep praying. I want you to pray for the people in the front here. Would you do that? If you can't come down and pray with them personally, I want you to be praying right now, interceding at your seat for them.
Walk with me through fire. Heal all my disease. I trust in you. I trust in you. I believe you're my healer. I believe you are all I need. You're all. Storms, you walk with me through the fire, and heal all my disease. Oh, and my world in your hands. You're all I need, you're all I need, yeah. I believe
you're my healer.
Oh, I have faith in you,
I
Lord.
You are all I need.
All I have to do is say your name. All I have to do is say your name.
I believe you're my healer. You're all I need. Oh, yeah, nothing
is impossible.
Nothing's impossible.
Nothing is impossible.
No, nothing's impossible.
Nothing is
impossible.
You're more than enough for me.
You're all I need, you're all I need. Jesus, you're all I need. Oh, you're all I need, yeah.
Jesus, you're
all I need, yeah.
Jesus, you're all
oh, in the midnight hour.
Jesus,
oh, in the flood, Lord, and the fire. You're all I need.
You're all
I need. Jesus, you're all I need.
I believe you're my healer.
You can heal me. I just say your name, Jesus.
I believe,
Jesus.
You're my portion.
We call out your name,
I believe,
Jesus.
More than enough for me.
Oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus. Jesus, you're all. Jesus, you're all I need. You hold my every moment, and you calm my raging sea. Oh, you walk with me. You walk with me through fire. Oh, and you heal me. You heal me of all disease. Oh, and I trust in you, yes. I trust in you, yeah. And I believe.
Sing that out tonight.
You're my healer.
And I believe you're my healer. You're all I need, Lord.
And I believe you're my portion. And I believe you're more than enough for me.
You're more than enough.
Jesus, you're all I need.
You're more than enough, Lord. How many of you know he's more than enough tonight? He's more than you need. What is your name? Cody. I met you at Celebrate Recovery the other night. I want you to know I don't know you very well. This is my second time to see you. I see the Holy Spirit over top of you. I see the power of God around you. You have struggled. You have failed many times, but I'm telling you, you are on a right path right now. God is going to do something. If I try to speak something over you, it'll fall flat. I'm telling you, the Holy Spirit is speaking over you. Your victory is right in front of you. There's a prize. There's a cross, a finish line that's coming up for you. You're going to get through this to where you are then completely working to help others, to pull them up out of the gutter everywhere you go. You're there. You hold on, you endure, and you fight, because I'm telling you, you are right there. The Holy Spirit is speaking over you. There is an empowerment of strength being poured out on you in this house tonight, and you're going to leave here different. You're going to sleep different tonight than you have in a long time. God's going to show you there's something going on with you tonight. Cody, the Holy Spirit is working for you. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Libby. Stand up. Rocky, get up right there next to your wife. You are quiet, but you're a firehouse. You're a powerhouse for God. You know how to get a hold of the Lord. You've got that inside you. I'm telling you, the Holy Spirit, I see him over you tonight. You have had, you're laying things in front of him. You're walking by faith. and you're walking almost in a dark place, just saying, but by faith. Sometimes we just walk by faith, and I'm walking by faith. You're wounded, you're hurt, but you're okay because you're tough. You're tough. But I'm telling you, the Holy Spirit is bringing comfort and bringing peace. He's bringing peace into your spirit tonight. You are not going to have to fight for it. The Holy Spirit's going to let it rain on you. I'm telling you, there's a comfort that's going to come to you tonight that you haven't had in a long time. I'm all in the name of Jesus. Rocky, lay hands on your wife right there where you are. I want you to stretch your hands towards Libby. In the name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, we feel and sense you at work in this place. Touch by your power, Lord, and minister as you are already doing. Lord, let your empowerment, your service, let it be done in her right now. Speak that word of peace over her. Touch her by the power, Lord, that is ours through faith in Jesus Christ. Minister to her need. Speak to her now. Let there be a transformation of circumstance starting right now. Let the favor of the Lord go before her. Let the fountains open up, the windows of heaven open up, and let her begin to see now answers to her held faith. Let her see it from this moment forward in the name of Jesus Christ. And we thank you, Lord. We receive it by your Holy Spirit. We give you honor and we give you praise. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Is this all right? Say amen. Is this all right? Say amen. I just feel the flow with the Spirit here. You know me, man. It has to be a move of God. I'm not going to do this. I don't do this, but I'm doing it tonight. Doing it tonight. I won't stand up. The Lord spoke your name to me twice. You didn't come all the way over here from Australia just to sit in a service on Sunday night at Stratford Heights. I want you to stretch your hands towards this family. They are called of God, anointed of God. They're going back across the pond on the other side of the earth, but the power of the Holy Spirit has brought them here, but to do a marabai and denabrakohosi, to do a mighty work in them. Oh, in the name of Jesus. Lord, lay your hand on her, this pastor's wife, this minister's wife, this one that has a calling on her own life, Lord, to speak as an oracle of the Lord. Touch her by your mighty Holy Spirit. Let women be transformed and changed in their ministries around the country, Lord. I pray you'll call her into opportunity after opportunity. In the name of Jesus, we believe you tonight, Lord, for miraculous opportunities for both of them in the name of Jesus. I will speak this by the Spirit right now. Fred, stand up here next to your wife. I speak this by the Spirit. You have seen nothing yet. What God is going to do, mark it down in a book so you can go back and memorialize it as an altar before the Lord. God is going to open up opportunities in your country and in other places around the world. God is going to make provision happen. It's going to be a favor and a blessing that comes straight from the windows of heaven. You're going to see the work of God unfold, and God is going to use you. People will be healed. They will be transformed. They will be changed, and they will be saved by the scores. God is going to use you as a mighty force for his glory in the name of Jesus Christ. And Lord, we pray over little Kayla, sweet little Kayla, talented and gifted and called of the Lord, dedicated to you. Lord, let your work be done through her life. We commit her to you tonight and thank you for the work that you're doing, and by your Holy Spirit in her precious little heart, I thank you for her. And in the name of Jesus Christ, you will use her and you will make opportunity in the name of Jesus, for you have a plan that is beyond their own imagination. And I thank you for that truth that comes to them tonight through your Spirit. In Jesus' name, would you help me? Just give praise to the Lord and give honor to him right now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Where's Cameron? I want all the young people, everybody involved in Oasis, to stand up right here. I want you, many of you that will, I want you to get out. Come right now, and I want you to stand behind. Is Whitney here? Okay, it's all right. She'll get prayed for with you. She's one with you. I want every one of you to get around him, and I want you to pray as good as you can pray. I want you to pray that God will touch your youth minister, that he will become a flame of fire, protected, that God will protect his ministry, protect his house, protect his babies, that God will protect him. The enemy would love for every one of you to just go down the wrong road and to get off track, and God has put it on him to be your pastor. I want you to pray over him right now. I want you to stretch your hands good and through this crowd and get around him. And I want you to pray. And I want you to pray. Pray for Cameron Jones right here, our youth pastor. I'm believing God to touch him right now and empower him in the name of Jesus. Give the Lord praise tonight. Give him honor. Lord, we give you honor. We give you praise. This is your work tonight, and we thank you. We honor you tonight, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Now I want as many of you as I can. I know some of you are sitting down. If you're sitting down, stay sitting down. That's fine. But here's what I feel. I want all our pastors to come across the front right here. There's some of you in here tonight. You need a touch from God. You don't have to have bursitis. You don't have to have some mammoth need that's big and that you feel like you need to come. I mean, you just need a touch from the Lord. You want God to touch you and to minister in your spirit. You want the Holy, whoever is hungry for a touch of the Lord, I want you to get out of your seat and make your way to this altar. We're all going to get around you. I'm going to find you. We're going to pray for you. We're opening up this altar right now for the hungry. We're opening this altar now for the thirsty, for those who are hungry for God and you want a touch from the Lord in the name of Jesus. I want you to help us, Frederick and Jacqueline. I want you to help us.
You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken, yeah. Great are you, Lord. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lives. Pour out our praise, it's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise to you only, God. Oh, great are you, Lord. You're great, Lord. Great are you. Love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken.
Great are you, Lord. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your breath, God,
in our lungs.
In our lungs.
So we pour,
so
out,
we pour
praise,
it out.
Pour
yeah,
out
we pour
praise,
it out. It's your breath,
in,
yeah.
our lungs.
In our lungs.
So we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your breath, in our lungs. So we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise to you, only God.
Oh, we pour out our praise, yeah. Oh, we cry out, Lord, your grace.
Oh, and all the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Great are you, Lord.
Oh, yes.
All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing.
Great.
Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing.
Great,
great are you, Lord.
Oh, and
all the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing.
Will shout your praise.
Our hearts will cry.
Oh, our hearts will cry.
Will
oh, your grace.
Are you, Lord? It's your breath in our lungs.
know you're great. Great are you, Lord. Oh, yes, and all the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. Oh, and all the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Great, great are you, Lord. Oh, and it's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your breath, God, yeah.
Shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing.
It's your bed. So we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your breath.
Wow. Anybody in here feel that empowerment, that satisfying touch of the Holy Spirit in your life tonight? Anyone at all? Amen. It's your breath in my lungs, so I pour out your praise.
Pour out our praise.
It's your breath. In my love,
so we pour out our praise, pour out our praise.
It's your breath
in our love, in our love. So we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's
we
your
praise
breath
you
in our love.
We love
so
you.
So we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your
we
breath
honor you.
So we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your breath,
it's your breath
in my love,
in my love.
So we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your breath.
Hallelujah. Father, we honor you tonight. We don't always know what's going on and why you move in a certain way when you move like you did tonight. But I feel like we needed it. And I thank you for being an on-time God. Lord, you're empowering your people. The enemy, he works on us all week long. Sometimes we just need to go in for an overhaul from your Holy Spirit. Sometimes we can't know what to pray ourselves. Sometimes we don't know exactly how we're supposed to pray or get a hold of you. Sometimes, Lord, we work so hard at trying to be okay ourselves that sometimes we just need you to empower us, touch us. Thank you for your touch tonight. We believe in the power of your word. In the scriptures that talks about how when the Spirit of the Lord fell in the tabernacle, so thick and so strong that even the ministers couldn't minister. Lord, I believe we've had such an encounter this evening. We believe, Lord, that you're a God who is, you're outside of our boxes of religion. That, Lord, while you appreciate and you love the church and you are the one who founded the church, the true church on the rock. Jesus, you spent a lot of time making sure the churches in Revelation understood and knew where they had gotten off track. And Lord, churches, our church can get off track at times. But that's why we're so thankful that every now and again you just stop everything and realign and refocus and readjust all of our attitudes and our spirits. And you touch people like you did tonight. I thank you for ministry in this house. I thank you, Lord, for healing in this house. And thank you, Father, for direction and guidance. Most of all, I just thank you for the water, for the drink that we have had this evening. We honor you. We praise you. Lord, I pray that, you know, and part of me wonders or will inquire of you later tonight if this is because we're fixing to go through a couple of days, Lord, where we'll need supernatural empowerment as we haven't had before. Thank you, Lord, for moving in this service, getting us ready to honor our pastor emeritus, who we have loved and, Lord, we're grieving and hurting over. Lord, there'll be lots of folks here. There'll be a lot of people coming in from out of town and out of state. I just pray that when they come to see the legacy of Jack Watkins, they'll see there's a fire in the firehouse of the Lord. Lord, there's a work, a legacy that he's left behind because he was a man of faith and a man of God. Because, Lord, all the glory, all the honor, all the praise, it all belongs to you. We love you tonight. We thank you, Lord Jesus. And go with our people. Bless their hearts, their lives, their homes. Many of them will go home tonight to sleep like they haven't slept in a long time. Many of them will go home to circumstances that have begun already to change. I thank you, Lord, for answered prayer in this house. I thank you for faith in this house and for mountains that have begun to shake, rattle, and roll. We give you the honor for it all, and we pray it in your name. Amen. Amen. God bless you.
You've been watching the worship service from the Stratford Heights Church of God. On behalf of Pastor Ray, we thank you for spending your time with us. Stratford Heights is always available to hear from you. For more information, visit us online at shcog.com.
All the young people staying for the SFX, please be careful going and getting food and coming back. We'll be here all night.
This broadcast is made possible from people just like you who come together to worship the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Whenever you're in the southwestern Ohio area, we would love to have you join us for service. Our Sunday service schedule is at 8:30 and 10:40 a.m. and at 6 p.m. Sunday evenings. On Monday, it's Celebrate Recovery. Tuesday, the Oasis Youth Group. Wednesday night, it's the Family Life Night. And Thursday, the Esperanza Hispanic Worship Service. Please join us at the Stratford Heights Church of God in Middletown, Ohio.